This episode of MMA Nuts is brought to you by Hayabusa. Save 20% off with code MARCHNUTS at HayabusaFight.com. UFCstore.com. Get free shipping with orders of $75 or more with code MMA Nuts. Media Temple. Save 33% off hosting for the first 3 months with code MMA. Save 20% off with code MMA Nuts at ProtectTheBed.com. DefenseSoap.com. Serious soap for serious athletes. Save 15% off with code MMA Nuts. Hey fans, MMA Nuts, episode 284.
284.
My name is Ingo Weigold.
Matt Groth, MMA Show, by our fans, for our fans, we walk the line between serious and ridiculous. Ba-pew, motherfucker.
I feel like Wile E. Coyote's one like, ping, ping, ping. Roadrunner.
Ricochet Rabbit.
Yes.
Happening.
What's happening? Life is happening, man.
It's all good in the hood.
Yes. Which hood?
I don't know.
Your hood?
The
our hood?
That hood? The hood? Over here. The
neighborhood?
The 630.
Yes.
To get that tattooed on my arm, you 630. Know? 630. Fucking John Anik, you son of a bitch.
Yes.
No, it's debatable when I put that question out there last week. Bitch or not, a lot of people said, man of his word.
Yeah, he is. I mean, he's that. I'm okay with it. It's a cool story.
I guess his big ass tattoo.
He didn't have to make it that big. He could have made it tiny, like on his wrist. I still want to get a tattoo. I haven't figured out what. It's coming.
Retarded.
Yeah, it's coming. I feel like next couple years, around 40.
You're going to get a tattoo?
Yes, on my forehead.
You should. Like a big swastika. Cock and balls.
Cock. Swastika.
Swastika.
Cock. Swastika cock. I'm trying to debate.
I'm going to try to debate. Which one will be better for your health?
I'm not sure.
I guess neither.
Yeah, that's right. So.
Good.
Cock tattoo right on my forehead. Explain that to people.
That just shows you mean business. Right. You're not afraid to party.
I came here to fucking chew bubblegum.
Anyways. It's all good.
So dude, why is it that Australia seems to always get like the crazy cards where crazy shit happens?
Because they have the best reps in the business.
They do?
Steve Percival for president! He's going to put Donald Trump straight out of business.
You think?
I don't know.
Maybe.
Now he's wondered why, when they had cards in overseas, that everyone was booing this guy, Steve Percival.
Yeah.
And then we saw this Neil Magny versus Hector Lombard fight. What happened, man? And going into this fight, didn't you think Lombard was going to pretty much run away with this?
Yeah, I thought so.
I kind of thought that.
Should have, but Neil, obviously training with Damien or something, or... That guy, I was looking at his record just earlier today.
Yeah.
Dude, he's fought like all over the world. Every fight is like in some other country.
You're
all
going
the time.
To Zimbabwe.
He's crazy, man. That guy's tough, and he's from Chicago. So I remember we saw him in Wisconsin way back in the day on the same card that Jonathan's fought on. Like he was the main event on that. And so impressive. I mean, he gets all destroyed in the first round. Should have been stopped
toughest.
Like what, maybe twice, three times?
Four Probably. Times. I mean, and how about how many illegal blows did Hector Lombard? I saw were like 20 blows to the back of the head. Steve Percival, fight on.
It's all good.
Fight on!
Still
the
breathing?
Man says.
You're good. Your eyes open? Good. Good.
Okay.
Yeah. Second round, different story.
Yeah.
Like a total 180.
My gas tank, not so much there.
Yeah.
My Hercules power is not so Herculean.
I don't understand how you don't stop it there either. The guy's like...
He's flattened like, out, belly down,
yes.
Back mount, pounding away. I think people were posting Mark Goddard in the crowd, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's like, oh my God.
I cannot watch this.
Yeah.
Gross.
Showing all his reactions to this fight.
Yep. Brutal.
Steve Percival, fight on.
Yep. And Neil, of course, finished it early in the third.
Should have stopped at the second.
But I think it's a matter of Hector. Do we say Homer Simpson, Neil Magny? Is that what?
Another one?
Pretty much.
This is a little reminiscent of the Conor McGregor, Nate Diaz fight. Is what you're trying to say?
I will eat your punches, and then you will get tired. That's what's going to happen.
And I don't mind that, because that was the old Overeem. It was always, he's going to go out in a bang, he's either going to knock you out in the first round, or he's fucked.
Pretty much.
And it's kind of Rumble Johnson. He's going to knock you out in the first round or he's fucked.
Yeah.
I like that approach sometimes. I can't
Hector
lie.
Still looked huge, dude. What kind of shit is that guy on?
Hey, he just got done with his PED suspension.
Yeah. They're testing him for like next old level shit. You need to test him for next level shit. That guy's definitely on something. Come on.
Well, he needs better stuff because he needs the EPO.
Yeah.
So he doesn't gas out.
Maybe they're testing for that, Matt. Is there something they don't test for that
delivers maximum stamina, like loads rectally.
Yeah, just start taking lots and lots of horse loads to the ass.
Nice.
And you'll perform well.
Jesus.
If not the best ever.
Okay, perfect. So, what did you think about the fight? Exciting, not exciting?
Yeah, I liked it because it's a little back and forth. Thought it was weird that we didn't have any 10-8 scores when I thought round one is a 10-8, yep. Round two is a 10-8.
I hit it as a draw going into the third. I was like, these guys are tied up.
I could have been finished in the first, should have been finished in the second, gets finished in the third.
I don't know.
Crazy.
What are you going to do, though? This shit happens.
Fire Steve Percival.
Never going to happen.
I should never ref again. And I don't know what to do next for these guys. I looked at it. I don't know.
I was reading like Neil should get like Dong Young Kim or something. Dong Young.
The stun gun.
Yeah. Is that his name?
Yes.
Yeah. Something like this. I don't know. He's kind of like in that middle ground. He's not quite ranked high enough. He's not.
Well, he just his only loss in a handful of fights, like 7 or 8 fights, was Maya, which is a tough fight.
That was his big.
So he really needs like a top five, and it's.
Who's that going to be?
It's tough. Condit says he's going to hold out until he gets a title shot. Lawler, we don't know. You have Thompson fighting Rory MacDonald.
Mm-hmm.
And you have Hendricks still floating around, but he's coming off a loss. So, and then Woodley up there, too.
You ever fight Matt Brown? Could he fight
Woodley,
Matt Brown?
Well, Brown's going to fight Maya next.
Oh, that's right. I forgot that.
Which,
that's a
which
done deal.
Will be a weird one because that's two fighters that have been on the show.
Mm-hmm.
They're actually going to fight, so I don't know who to root for.
That is true. That is weird.
We've never had this happen before.
We haven't had that many guests. How come
not so many? Well, we did for a while. We were going down that round, and we said, fuck it. We could, but we're not
going to. I don't need guests. It's more fun just us.
Exactly.
Okay.
I just want to be retarded
in
my own world. Mildly retarded.
Mildly retarded.
Right?
Yes.
Give it to me.
Nothing. I'm just going to like...
Come on. Never go full retarded. Never go full retarded. You know what's funny is that my daughter uses that retarded word now. In the correct way. She's like, this is so retarded. Why am I doing
totally
this?
Totally retarded. The older one or the younger one?
The older.
Oh, nice. Okay.
I'm trying to slowly introduce the young one.
To the madisms?
Yeah.
Yes.
You need to start using this vernacular.
Print it! That's coming next.
Print it.
One and done. Okay.
It's all good. So, let's move right along.
Yes.
Mark Hunt, Frank Mir, again, the master of the walk-off KO. Clunk.
How does he know? Does he have sensors in his hand?
I think he can scan. He might be the Terminator with how he looks at someone after he drops him. He's like, we're good.
Yeah.
And then I'm having a huge after party. Everybody come hang out with me. We're going to drink. There's only a $200 cover. I'm just fucking with you guys. It's a $25 cover, but come and drink with me.
I thought he wasn't allowed to do that.
He doesn't. That's Mark Hunt. He doesn't give a shit.
Okay.
He's like Chuck Norris now,
doesn't
man.
Care. He's bigger than, larger than life.
Like, who else? Well, that's what I'm saying. Who else can do walk-off KOs? Anderson Silva can't pull that shit off.
Not anymore. No, I mean, it's pretty impressive. He's done it multiple times in the last few years.
No, the ref doesn't decide when the fight's over. Mark Hunt decides when the fight's over.
I'm done.
He is Chuck Norris.
Turned his back and walked away. I was like, that's it.
I thought he, and that's a little bit of respect. How about that, right? He could have easily went down there and delivered a lot more substantial punishment.
Yep.
Not that Frank Mir needs any more at that point.
Yeah.
I think that was great. I think we need that. That's a classy move. That was Lyoto Machida on Mark Munoz when he cranked him and could have teed off again and walked off.
Yep.
Oh, mutual respect.
Exactly. Yeah, I wonder if you KO guys enough, you just kind of know. It's like when you, like those home run sluggers, you know, when they just kind of like, they go, yep, that's gone. See you later. Maybe just like a feeling there, like some kind of like, just the energy transfer. You kind of just know, you're like, that's it. It's over.
You've done it enough.
And poor Frank, man. It is time to retire. I mean, his body looks different. He looks different.
Horrible body-wise.
Yeah, and you know the Duffy fight is not like he was looking like a world beater. It just happened that
Duffy's
had, like,
swinging
like a crazy.
Hey, look at this hook! I have a stiff right arm coming at you.
Exactly.
Clunk.
I'm worried about his safety at this point. It ain't the first time he's been KO'd. So
I forgot what it was. 3 out of his last 8, I think, he got KO'd on.
Quite a few.
And he's only won 2 of his last 8 fights. So
exactly.
He's a guy who is smart, well-spoken, can have a career as a commentator slash analyst, and probably should.
Yeah.
Would be a lot better than fucking Brian Stann. I can't
you
stand
like Brian Stann?
Not at all. I think he is the worst. And I don't want to talk bad about him, but I think he's the worst.
He's a little, he's got that like anal military type, you know, black is black and white is black kind of situation going on there.
He won't give me the fight. He's talking about this guy's been training Muay Thai in 150 degree sauna for the last 4 weeks while his testicles have been dragging across sandpaper, trying to get a little grittier than normal.
Yes.
Motherfucker. Tell me about what's going on in the octagon right now. I don't need to know about what he's been doing the last 8 weeks. I don't give a shit. I want right now, the moment.
Yeah.
And I'm not getting it from him. Here's my rankings.
Okay.
Brian Stann. Kenny Florian is above Brian Stann.
Oh, wow.
And you know my feelings on Kenny Florian.
Don Anik?
I prefer Anik over all three of them. Anik, Florian, Stann.
Yikes.
Annex on the top.
Okay.
And that shows you where I'm at.
Well, Mira was great in the WEC.
He's the best.
But then there was that whole I'm going to kill you thing, and that kind of ruined things for a while. So he was going to kill Brock Lesnar, right?
Right.
Octagon-related death, I believe, was the exact quote.
That was around the time. We're going to reminisce a little bit. But this, that was the times when people would make rape jokes on Twitter and then get fucking banned. Who was it? Miguel Torres?
Miguel Torres got it. Yes. And, yeah, there was a couple. I don't remember who. Anthony Johnson, maybe? No.
No, but then everyone, their accounts would get hacked.
Yes.
I didn't say that.
Oh, sorry, it's not me.
We went through that for a few
what
years.
Done?
But now, I think you could say, I want to murder that guy and get away with it.
Yeah.
It's eased up. I think as we've, I don't know, as a society, we're more accepting to crazy shit being said like that.
Like rape?
No, like rape? Murder.
Oh, murder. Or... I like everybody's thing now is like, I'm willing to die in there. I'm like, really?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. This is a sport. Like, you don't need to be talking about death.
That was Ensign Inouye talking about that in his book. He always was ready to die every time I went to battle.
Yes. But he's a true warrior.
I get it.
I mean,
that's
sure.
Would you, how you want to operate, but
sure.
No, it is a sport at this point. There are people to prevent that from happening.
Hopefully.
You're not in the street.
Unless it's, what's that guy's name? Steve.
Which one?
What's the guy?
Steve Percival?
That's it.
He might kill you.
Might let you
because
die.
When you talk about him, that's how you get the John Jones versus Matt Hamill situation happen.
Oh, yeah.
Because when someone's just beating the fuck out of someone to the point that you're not stopping it, so now you're getting more aggressive with your strikes, and oh, shit, a 12-6 elbow.
Yep.
Had nothing to do with the outcome of the fight. That guy was going to lose regardless, but made John go more aggressive. So that's what's going to happen in a Percival fight. You watch.
Mm.
Someone's going to get a little more aggressive and get fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
That guy should never be ref ever again.
Ever. You know what? Mark Hunt deserves a title shot.
Another. God damn it.
Yes, he does.
I'm good for that. We got who? Radum and Miocic are fighting here shortly. I'd like to see him fight winner of Overeem versus Arlovsky.
Hmm, that was a good one. Did he fight? I swear he fought one of them. No,
he's fought Overeem before.
Yeah, I was gonna say, yeah.
I think Overeem key locked him way back in the
day.
Yeah, all his submissions were by arm.
Mm-hmm.
And Mir couldn't get him down to the ground. Mir, his takedowns, he was just off.
Yeah. Well, they've never been great. I think Mir's always capitalized in weird situations. And I don't know. He's just slow and old and not himself and looking slimmer yet pudgier yet.
Well, this makes the case for TRT for the old guys.
Oh, yeah.
Just get him. You don't have to go crazy Vitor Belfort level, but just a little above whatever he's at now, 200, get him the 6, I don't know.
Yeah, why not? I just always think of Mir versus, like, Brock Mir. When Brock came on the scene, Mir was like, I gotta get bigger! Like, get as big as possible.
Yeah.
How huge that guy was for, like, fucking a year.
He's
gigantic. There's all those videos of him just lifting crazy weights and all this shit. And look at him now.
Yeah, it's a shell of his former self. I don't like to see this as these guys get older. I mean, yes, in the heavyweight division, you can go older and maybe get a little bit out of shape, but I think we're both in agreement. It's time for him to step away.
Yeah.
Respectfully.
Yeah, they say the heavyweights hit their prime in like the early 30s, right? 32.
I'd say probably 35.
35
seems
even?
To be the prime.
Okay.
I want to say the average age is 36.
Oh, wow. Okay. Didn't realize it was that
it's
high.
Old. I mean, by far the oldest weight class out of everyone.
Yeah.
Which is weird.
It is weird.
So, Mark Hunt, Frank Mir.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. Moving right along. The news.
Please.
Matt Mitrione signs with Bellator.
Yes.
I love what we're seeing here. So here's the deal. Rumored to be a four-fight contract. Each fight guaranteed six figures. Ooh. It's going to be a commentator for Bellator kickboxing.
Nice.
He's also making double, in quotes, what the UFC offered him as show and win money.
Nice.
Wow.
They're paying people, man. They're paying some money. Paying some monies. I don't think the UFC wants to pay anybody. Any monies. Only the big guys.
Yeah.
So they're going to lose all these little guys. It's going to keep happening over there.
Well, we lost Benson Henderson.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Matt Mitrione, you're probably okay to lose him. It's not going to hurt. And Mitrione's, like, angling for a fight with Fedor.
Ooh, that would be cool.
Which, hey, man, why not?
Actually, they're very similar styles. That would be interesting. Both athletic big guys with some power.
Mm-hmm. Fedor, more speed, but the power is still
right,
there.
Right.
And some people were talking about maybe a Mitrione versus Kimbo Slice, but I don't think Kimbo's going to get anywhere near Matt again.
No.
The last time, remember him just chopping him with leg kick?
Yeah.
Leg kick, leg kick, leg
kick.
Yeah,
it was brutal.
Oh, Kimbo, your knees are so done.
Oh, yeah.
They're not going to let him anywhere near him.
No.
And even Justin Wren was trying to get a Kimbo fight. He's not going to get a Kimbo fight. Kimbo's only going to get freak shows. He's not going to get legitimate contenders. So.
Pretty much.
So we got that going on. And then would you have Rory MacDonald? What's going on with
him? Yeah, apparently, you know, he said he's going to fight out his contract, right? He's got, what, one left? And going to test the market. It's very strange because, you know, he's a young guy. He's fought for the title. I mean, there's been, like, a lot of shit with him. Why would they let him go? I don't get it. It doesn't make sense. He's got the GSP lineage. You know, there's a lot of positives about that guy. I think they're willing to let him go. And, you know, I don't think they would match. If Bellator's got all this money, UFC's like, see you later. It's odd to me. I don't know. I find it really interesting that they're willing to let these guys just go.
Well, when he was on there, too, he was on the MMA Hour talking about this situation. Mm-hmm. Here's his quotes from that.
Your quotes.
He said, I want to make the most money I can. I want to get paid for what I bring to the table. I've sacrificed a lot to get to the top, to the world title. I really sacrificed and I took a lot of chances. I did a lot of favors. I felt like for the UFC, I don't think it got returned. So now it's all about making money and whoever wants to pay me the most is where I'll go. So he's underappreciated at the end of the day. And like you're saying, UFC just willing to let all these people go.
Yeah.
Almost, it's almost like they're trying to save money. Why would they be trying to save money at this point?
Well, the other part of that long quote that you wrote was he's talking about fighting for 50K or whatever, and he doesn't want to travel to make all this like this tiny amount of money and all that.
Because he was supposed to fight Hector Lombard in Australia.
He doesn't want to do it for 50 grand, he
says. Like, I'll fight him, but not overseas. Let's do it in London or somewhere that's, you know, a little bit closer so I don't have to make that flight and waste all that money flying all the way over there.
Yeah. It's a lot of expenses, and it just seems oddly strange to me that the UFC is willing to let some of these guys go, and there's a lot of rumors flying around again about China, big money coming in to trying to buy this shit. So, you know, we had been talking about this before the show a bit, and what was your take? You think they're angling for a sale?
Well, you look at all the stuff. We've talked about it in the past, too, so... You do this crazy drug testing program, so you're trying to clean the sport up from a drug testing side of it. Reebok, you bring a legitimate sponsor in and clean up and make all the fighters wear uniforms.
Right, which is boring.
And you cut all their pay. You're basically, you short-sighted all the fighters. You don't give a shit what the fighters are.
Nope.
And they used to care about them. Remember when they gave them some sort of health insurance?
Oh, absolutely.
Whatever. They let them get their own sponsors, and now it's gone the exact opposite. 180 degrees opposite direction of fuck the fighter. Mm-hmm. We need to get as much money in as possible. And in my mind, it's... And even at the end of last year, when they tried to dump all those pay-per-views or all those extra events that weren't scheduled, like December, let's do three fights in a row, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Yep.
And what are you guys doing? Why are you trying to cram it in? Are you trying to hit a revenue number?
And Dana's pulled way back from the whole thing. It's odd. He was always in the front.
And there are a lot of rumors floating around about a sale to China.
Mm-hmm.
Just it's,
billions. I heard something like $4 billion or something.
I heard six.
Six?
Six oh being floating around.
Jesus.
They're trying to get that valuation.
Fucking hell. If you, I'd sell two. $6 billion? Are you kidding me?
Later. But what are they running from? That's the question. Is it because of this lawsuit and the union? And I mean, something's going to come of all that.
Well, no, I mean, if you've been grinding at something forever, and you know, there comes a point where you might be like, all right, $6 billion? Okay. See you later.
Maybe they want to buy. I thought there was a rumor that the Fertittas wanted to buy another team. Maybe a, I don't know if it was an NFL team.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So like maybe
a Vegas NFL team, something weird like this. Well, they need a lot of money for that. So look at, I mean, the Dallas Stadium, I think, cost like $2 billion to build.
But didn't the taxpayers have to pay a shit ton of that,
they,
too?
Yeah, they did, but, you know, there's still, you know, everything else around it. So, you know, you need some cash, man, to do some fucking football. I didn't realize they were football fans. I mean, that's a lot less exciting than martial arts, but I don't know, dude. It's weird. It seems like next few months, 6 months, 8 months, some shit's going to go down. So
yeah, it'll be weird. I mean, it can be good or bad. You just don't know what the new owners are going to do. If there are new owners, right?
Yes.
We good or bad? I mean, you got to get rid of this fucking Reebok deal. At the end of the day, that's what's killing this fucking sport.
I hate it.
Even the video game people are complaining about this. You have the stupid uniforms in the Reebok game. Can you not get any more original?
Yeah.
It's a video game, for fuck's sake.
Have you played it?
No.
Okay. I got the EA Access thing, and I downloaded it. I mean, the game plays well, but you're right. It just feels like it's boring, man. It's like... Dude,
it's a video game.
Yeah.
It should be fun. It should be arcadey.
Yes.
You should be able to do whatever you want.
Yes.
You should be able to fight man versus woman, weight class versus weight class, pride rules, soccer.
They do have
kicks.
Joe Rogan, though, you can unlock, which is weird.
Great.
I haven't tried it yet.
That
but
doesn't solve all the
Joe
other
Rogan
problems.
Commentating on Joe Rogan.
With the old code, like up, down, up, down, left, right,
B-A,
whatever.
Select, start.
I thought it used to be A, B, 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 A. They changed it a little bit. I'm old school. I get it.
Hey,
I got it. I know it's good.
So, it remains to be seen. Hmm.
It does. You want to talk about uniforms or... well, I'm going to skip around then.
You're going to skip around?
So, we were talking about the uniforms, and Reebok put Donal'd Cerrone's patch on his fight shorts.
Hmm.
Kind of funny. The patch that he got fined thousands of dollars for his last fight. Now they're actually putting it on there.
Good for them. Got pictures?
Yeah, so...
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Like, oh, my God, that's great.
They're nice people, those Reebok people.
So that's the most creative product they've put out in the last 9 months of being with the UFC. You put a patch on.
Mm-hmm.
Yay!
Good job.
How hard was that? Like, fuck, okay, we got this patch. Where should we put it? Should we put it on the side? Mm-hmm. Put it right on his cock?
On his balls.
Wrap it around on a taint, maybe? Yes. As long as it's on there and it's not as visible... Maybe that's where it should go.
Yeah. Well, maybe I have a feeling there's probably a combination of that and also, like, listen, this guy's going to fucking create...
He's going to do it.
...create chaos every goddamn event. So let's just make him happy so we don't have to deal with this bullshit. You know, I'm sure they don't want to find fighters and all this shit either, but...
No.
So they kind of like, you know, he's a brand in a sense, you know? He's a well-known guy, so... You know, you think like the Diaz brothers, people like that who have like a Conor McGregor, people who have this aura.
That you might want to put 209 on their fucking
Hells
shorts.
Hells yeah, why not?
You're 9 months in the deal. When are we going to get some new uniforms? The black and white, and white and black are driving me fucking bananas so bad.
They'd probably sell more shit if they did some stuff like this.
Right, and that goes back to the point of, obviously, that's not on their mind. They don't care what they're selling, if they're making money or not. It's just, that tells me the short-sightedness of this. And even to the point where, if you want to talk about UFC 200, we're looking, the rumor is now, right, that they're trying to do Conor McGregor versus Nate Diaz 2 and doing it at 170 again?
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on that?
I hate it. I mean, I really do. I don't know what would be the goddamn motivation for that, because they've already done it and it's already happened. And I mean, what are you going to do now? Diaz has a full fight camp and he makes it even more of a ass beating. I mean, what is it going to be? Okay, Conor boxed them up a little bit. Okay, so what? They both have a fight camp now. Diaz has got ridiculous cardio. Conor still has not enough power to knock him out. So what's going to happen?
He's going to develop an awesome ground game within 3 months. He's going to go to the Dave Herman School of Jiu-Jitsu.
Ah, he doesn't believe in Jiu-Jitsu.
That's right. It doesn't work, motherfucker.
It doesn't matter. Yeah, I don't get it. At 155, maybe. Sure. Even then, I don't know. I feel like it's a big, like, just cash grab. There's so many other fights they could make. And I don't want to see it again. Not now. Maybe if there's something on the line, right? If Diaz has the belt at 170, okay. Now I'm listening. That's a potential. But
whatever. Again, it seems short-sighted. Yeah. If this fight is to go through, it's a cash grab.
Yeah.
And I question the UFC's motives. Are you doing this to destroy Conor McGregor? Yeah. Was Conor McGregor getting bigger than the UFC?
Could be.
And how do you take him down a notch? You make him lose.
Twice.
And we talked about two losses in a row. Who is that more devastating for? Is it Ronda Rousey or is it Conor McGregor? It might be Conor McGregor now that I think about it.
Could be.
Last week I thought it might have been Ronda.
Yeah.
Well, Ronda will be retired after two.
Well, at least Ronda has a movie career where McGregor does not. Yeah. He's just a fighter. But definitely, how do you go back and market yourself as a champion after you've lost twice?
Hard.
And
he has to go back to 45 for his next fight.
Yeah.
And if I'm him, I fight Aldo. No part of Edgar. No part of Edgar. Just stay away from him.
Hell no. Nobody wants to fight Frankie Edgar. Love it. Poor guy, man. He's good. Developed a reputation of like, God, you can't stop this guy.
He has had the most rematches, I think, out of anybody ever. More so like BJ Penn. Then you have a bunch with Benson Henderson, Gray Maynard. I think that's where it started, too.
Yeah.
You have a draw. If you had the right ref in that fight, they might have stopped it in that first round, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then we don't have this conversation because he's out of relevancy.
Yeah. But the guy's like tough as shit. Nobody wants to fight guys like that. It's like, I don't want to take that fight. That guy's way too tough.
Yeah.
You know, like, he may not beat me, but dude, that's going to be a hard fight. I don't want to mess with that. Let's do this over here.
He could get tired. He's just going to keep coming after you and coming after you. Take you down. Yep. You want no part of that.
So we'll see. I think they'll do this fight, the Diaz-McGregor
thing. I don't know. I got a theory. I think this is a smokescreen.
For what?
I think they're... the UFC is kind of smart at times, where they throw shit out and see what sticks. So they throw it out, they see negative fan reaction to it. Maybe they're going to step away. I wonder if there's a bigger smokescreen, because when we look at UFC 200, they haven't really given us this awesome card where I'm going, oh my God, I got to fucking watch this. They're like, it's lukewarm from what I've heard.
Yeah.
And maybe this fight is a smokescreen. Maybe they're going to do Conor McGregor, BJ Penn, 155.
Ooh.
Then I'm intrigued.
I like this.
I don't know if he can come back from whatever BJ's got going on in the background.
Oh, I like it a lot, man. Two boxers, like strikers. BJ's, this is like the same fight as Diaz, except BJ's smaller.
Yes.
Maybe similarly crafty on the ground, except...
Not going to get knocked the fuck out.
Right.
He can get beat up. He's like Rory MacDonald beat him up pretty good.
Yep.
Nick Diaz beat him up pretty good. BJ Penn.
Yep.
Conor could box him up.
He could.
But will he get tired in the process?
I don't know. And BJ's not exactly known for his cardio.
Right.
But he's got all that, like, it's weird that rumor about him, like, came and was all hot and then it was
gone,
dead silent.
Man.
Like, there's no commentary about anything. He hasn't been officially reinstated that I read. There's been, like, no talk of him at all, which leads me to believe that maybe there's some legal shit going on that we don't know about.
Maybe.
You know? Or it's all water under the bridge. I don't know.
But, that's the question mark, right? Mm-hmm. We don't know. It's just the other fights, when we're talking about UFC 200, I think they said Cain Velasquez versus Travis Browne.
Mm-hmm.
Gegard Mousasi versus Derek Brunson. These are fights that I'm not getting pumped up for.
It's like the first and second fight. What's the third, fourth, and fifth fight?
So unless you got a GSP coming back, a BJ Penn, you got to have something in there that's going to blow my mind. And right now, nothing in there is blowing my mind. That shouldn't even be on the fucking main card. Unless that's the prelims that you're talking about, then I'm in. Then you're selling me.
Yes. Fight pass.
Like, oh, fight pass?
Bringing it in.
I like that. If we can put those fuckers on fight. And Cain Velasquez is going to pull out with an injury. So what are we even talking about?
Yeah.
That guy's never going to fight again. Done. He's done fighting. I'm off my soapbox. You better take a story.
All right. Hey, what do you got? I got something. How do you feel, speaking of like weird shit, Anderson Silva and Urijah Hall, UFC 198. Make sense?
No.
That makes sense?
No, it does not make sense. Anderson Silva is fucking 40 years old. He's in the twilight of his career.
Right?
He's off of PEDs. You know, he just lost to Michael Bisping. A little controversial with what was going on in there. On Michael Bisping's fault. Problem. Knee. That was Mark Hunt. That fight's over. Anderson Silva, not so much. He needs to be fighting classic fights at this point. If GSP was to come back. A GSP versus Anderson Silva
now at
UFC 200. Catch weight of whatever. 180. Let's do that. I don't want to see him going against young, tough guys.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense, does it?
No.
So I look at it almost as like a passing of the torch kind of a fight. Because they're both similar styles, exciting, weird, flashy stuff. Like, are they doing sort of like an... you know, like old guard, new guard, kind of passing the torch thing.
They did that when Rich Franklin came on the scene against Ken Shamrock.
Yes.
Total passing of the guard.
Oh, yeah.
The crazy thing is, Ken Shamrock's still fighting while Rich Franklin's retired.
Yes. Yeah, well, he's doing better in life. Well, I would say. Probably Rich.
Yeah,
smart guy, right? Mr. Math
Juicer. Well, he's not a juicer. He owns a juicing company.
Ain't worth it. Weighing your food and shit.
No. Not now. Unless you're going to come back out of fight. I'm the VP of ONE-FC and I'm going to come back and fight Ray Sefo, the president of World Series of Fighting.
Yes.
So, does that fight make sense? No. Let's scratch that one. Moving right along. Where do I want to go? Let's talk about Tim Means. So, he had failed the USADA random drug test, and they finally said it was due to a tainted supplement. They confirmed that.
Mm-hmm.
So USADA said that the 2-year ban is officially off the table now, which is cool. But it still sounds like he's going to get some kind of suspension.
Really?
Do you think that makes sense since USADA confirmed it was a tainted supplement? He didn't take that intentionally.
Mm-hmm.
Should he still get suspended?
Yeah, you probably have to.
Why?
Because he opens the door for, like, wishy-washiness. Like, I don't know. It's a tough... Because you're enforcing the rules, and at the end of the day, I know it's tainted, but he still ingested it. He could have chosen not to take it. So it's like, it sets a precedence, potentially, if you allow this for other guys to squeak by who are actually cheating. So unfortunately... He's got to eat a little something. It doesn't have to be severe, but maybe 6 months.
You know? How about if we're gonna do that? Then I say 3 months.
3 months. That's such a bullshit suspension.
I don't care because that's a bullshit rule. The guy should not get suspended. If we've confirmed that was if you ever looked at USADA's list of banned supplements, it is goddamn
huge.
Ridiculous.
Yes.
And if you're a fighter, you cannot send them your supplements to have them tested. You have to pay yourself to a third party to have them tested. So it's complete. It's 100% on the fighter what you're putting in your body, which is bullshit. You should be able to take a supplement, and I mean that goes to a bigger problem of the supplement companies putting shit in there, and there's no regulations. Nobody's saying, nobody's testing it. It's just you put a product out on the market. Go ahead.
There you go.
So I say as a fighter, you should not be suspended for that. I get what you're saying. Yeah, I'm sure people can and will abuse that by far, but...
A lot.
I mean, what the fuck? draw a line. 3 months is my line. If you want to make a statement, make a statement, USADA. 3 months, you fucking bastards. Like,
yeah.
Because someone else had a tainted supplement too. It's Yoel Romero. His was tainted.
Mm-hmm.
That is the body of a natural athlete. Okay. You know, and at, what, fuck anybody.
What the hell is that guy? he's like my age.
No, forget Jesus.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Is your internet's working, by the way? I think my iPad is taking a shiza. All of a sudden.
I don't know.
I got no internets.
I'm sure it'll all work
this
out.
This is bad. My stories are not loading.
Uh-oh.
Anyways.
Well, I hear the computer grinding, so maybe it's not.
It's down. Fuck you, Comcast.
Well, I'll give you the USADA random drug testing watch because there was some interesting shit that happened in this past week. If I can find my stories, I'm skipping all over the place. So we have 407 tests, 269 athletes tested. We're at 5.43 tests per day. Anderson Silva leading the pack with 9.
Okay.
Misha Tate is in second place now with 6, which I find interesting because she wasn't on the radar before. Mm-hmm. But all of a sudden... somebody wins the title that they don't want to win the title, so they test the fucking living shit out of her. Mm-hmm. She's at 6. And then we have Conor McGregor, Anthony Johnson, and Dama Cruz, who finally makes his appearance, all in third place with 5 random drug tests. So interesting to see who's getting tested more or not of late here.
Hmm.
Misha Tate.
Mm-hmm.
6. She wasn't on the radar before.
So she's been tested, like, every day.
I think they did that at the Holly Holm right when she beat Ronda Rousey.
To make sure.
Like, there's no way she could have fucking possibly beat her. Hey. You better keep testing her and testing her.
Mm-hmm.
See, Kat Zingano got a Nissan sponsorship, by the
way? No, when you said that earlier to me, I was like, wow.
She's throwing a big shout-out to...
Is she driving?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
So she posts that picture up.
I like the socks, man.
Damn nice. Right. I just want to say hooray for Kat Zingano. And you can get, if you're a, well, actually any fighter can get sponsorships outside of the UFC. You just got to get a little creative.
Yeah.
And I like that creativity.
I like the socks. Maybe she can just wear the socks only.
That's fine.
Fine.
And there is that rumor flowing around of maybe her and... Cris Cyborg at UFC 200.
Okay.
I'm in for that.
Sure.
Misha Tate said she's in for a little Cris Cyborg action at 140. Holly Holm's in for some Cris Cyborg action at 140.
Wow.
When is the UFC going to bring in Cris Cyborg? What are we waiting for?
Never.
Why?
She's probably...
She's not a threat to Rousey anymore.
She's. Yeah, but she's out of everybody the juice. Else? She's too big.
No, nah, she's been tested... Mm-hmm. I got to pull her up. I don't know if she's been tested this year.
Mm. You she's haven't on mentioned her as far as I recall. So huh? I mean, you haven't mentioned it from what I remember.
Well, I haven't looked her up. I'm sure she's on there. I want to see if she's gotten... I do remember her putting a post up of her getting random drug tests.
She's not in your top 5, though, right?
No. She's at least got 1. You don't need her tested a lot.
Just once.
Just once is good.
So we're going to test you in about 3 weeks, okay? On this day and this hour.
Just make sure we're cool. You cool?
See then. Bye-bye. Okay, it's all good.
That is all we need.
Yes.
And then I don't know if we're going to talk about this. I got 2 more things. We have that Colorado Athletic Commission suspending Justing Gathje.
Oh, God.
Indefinitely for his backflip off the cage.
I still don't understand that whole thing. Why?
Because it looked fucking awesome, and you don't want to have this picture of a guy doing awesome backflips.
It seems ridiculous.
And then the next day, they unsuspend him.
Oh, they did? Okay, good.
Why'd you even do it in the first place? Yes. Fuck off. Trying to make a name
for yourself.
He can't
do that. Oh, they hate us. All right, he can do it.
That's what weed does. You have legal weed, and then you're fucking out of control.
Fucking legal weed.
The last thing I want to talk about, this one we're going to get a little deep, is Matt Serra's comments on Conor McGregor and Holly Holm.
Yep.
Let me I'm going to read exactly what he said, and then give me your comments. So... This is Matt Serra. He says, I was out of my seat and fucking was just like, damn, it was fucking awesome. Listen, what a fucking warrior Holly is that she took a nap. You heard in the post-fight fucking press conference, they're like, well, why'd you choose to go to sleep? She didn't choose to go to sleep. She kept believing that if she got out, she could win the fight. Tapping wasn't a fucking option. How do you not respect that? Not being a cack, but look at Connor. All the shit you talk, take a nap, man. It's not like your arm was about to break. I understand you want your career, and if it was a knee bar, you'll be out for 6 months. But, dude, if worst comes to worst, you'll think you're in the bedroom. That's it. You'll wake up like, what the fuck? But everything will be all right. So what do you think about this? This tap or not to tap mentality?
Well, I appreciate where Sarah's coming from, being, and I understand his mentality.
Being a retard.
Yes, given where he's from. But I will say the two situations are millennium difference, okay? Holm had defended the choke multiple times and was still in a position to potentially get out.
Yeah.
In both, I mean, was it the second round or third when she defended for like a whole fucking round?
The second round.
Yeah, and at the end too, right? So I believe that she never had a chance to tap because she felt like she could get out, and then it's too late, right? Whatever.
Yeah.
You're out. McGregor, on the other hand, had no cardio left, decided to go for a takedown, and I believe chose the lesser of two evils of, you know.
Yeah,
sure. I don't think the guy's stupid. I think he's extremely intelligent, although he comes off as brash and whatever. Getting choked unconscious is way worse than tapping out.
And shitting your pants. Yeah,
it's way worse than tapping out. I would say, you know, fine. Yeah, nothing would have got broken, but his ego and his aura. Dude, you cannot get choked fucking unconscious. It just doesn't.
No, you can't make someone make you your bitch.
No.
Because then you could have just fucked you in the ass and you wouldn't have known it. At least you tapped out. It's done.
This mentality.
This tap or no tap.
I don't like it. I really don't, because you should know as a person who's if you're a black belt, McGregor's obviously not, but even if you aren't, you should know when you've been checkmated. It's a good time to say, all right, that's the whole thing about jiu-jitsu. You can tap anytime. It's okay. And there's no like respect loss. There's mm-hmm. no, as a matter of fact, there are those in the world that I know who would say that you're being disrespectful to your opponent by not tapping out. Because
Frank Mir and Nogueira, one was completely disrespectful. You force Frank Mir to fucking tear your shoulder off.
Yes.
Did he want to?
No. So you're making someone be brutal to you on purpose because you're being a fucking idiot. So I don't agree, Matt Serra. I really don't. I really don't agree. I think there's nothing wrong with tapping out. Sure. You know, I get where you're coming from. You're old school. You got the whole like Gracie thing and whatever. But dude, it's not the same. It isn't.
No, so. I agree. Each fighter is different, right?
Yeah.
You know, if I'm in that situation, what are you gonna gain? What is your gain? Do you get okay? Say Conor does get out.
Mm-hmm.
What does he have left to offer?
Nothing. He's got no more gas.
Oh, now I'm gonna get fucked up more. Well, now I get like you're saying. Now I get knocked out.
Yeah.
Oh, now I do get knee bar. Now I do get something broken. It's like the lesser of two evils.
Tapped out. Nothing wrong with it.
And like, say he's fighting Husamar or Paul Harris.
Yeah.
Oh, I tapped, but I got broke anyway. What the fuck? Yep. Asshole.
Yep. No, so. I mean, you can choose to end it anytime.
Right.
So there's nothing wrong with that.
I have no problem with that.
No,
I think
dude.
That's the wrong way of looking at fighting. You don't want to.
Yep.
Especially the younger kids, and you're telling, if you're going to be an instructor, which he is, you're trying to tell people don't tap. Now you're putting people in a position where he kind of qualified it to say, I get it if it was a knee bar or an arm bar, but maybe you're putting them in a position where they should be tapping and they're not because of the comments you're making.
Right.
So I think it's dangerous. You got to be a little careful. Dangerous. I don't agree.
Yeah. I don't know. This is old school shit. It's
needs bullshit.
It needs to be gone. It's not. I don't think it has a. Dude, this is why this sport gets a fucking bad reputation. Because I'm at work and people are like, "Oh, you like that? You like it because you guys are beat." I'm like, "Okay, when you watch it, that's what you see. When I watch it, that is not what I see. I don't see two idiots just bashing each other's brains in. Okay, I see a lot of technical stuff. I see a lot of guys doing things that you know." You will never understand until somebody takes you down on the ground and you can't do anything about it. They're literally you can literally not do a fucking thing about it, and they'll do whatever they want to you. You don't understand. That's not what I see when I see fighting. But people who have this mentality, that's what they project to the world. That's where you get the cockfighting and the fucking like to the death and all this bullshit. It ain't to the death, dude. It's a fucking sport.
Like, mm-hmm.
You know? It ain't. It's just not.
What happens when you crap your pants because you've been choked unconscious? How are you ever going to live that one down?
That? Is that
you're talking about? Grab my pants!
Chuck Liddell or whatever? Is that what you're talking about? No, he got knocked out. That whole picture of him supposedly shitting his pants?
Tim Sylvia, yeah. Yoel Romero.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't ever want to be the guy that shit his pants. Tap out.
Yeah.
Moving right along. I think that's all I have for news. Do you have anything else? So I'm scrolling back through. No, internets are broken.
The internets are broken. I just remember the one thing that for some reason the internet's not working. I know we had a whole discussion a few shows back about the Arlovsky fucking Overeem fight and how it was weird they're in the same camp and all that. And Jackson was talking about how they kind of worked that out. And basically the only reason he's cornering Arlovsky is because he told him he would. Like he promised him he would. And they're having the guys train at separate times. They're not in the gym together. So they kind of figured out a system and he's like still kind of like, we don't like it, but it's, you know, they're at the end of the day, they're all professionals. So they're kind of making it work, but it sounds like they're not happy about it. So, you know.
Well, and I think the biggest difference between the John Jones and Rashad Evans versus this Andre Arlovsky and Alistair Overeem situation is Rashad and John were training together. They were training partners.
They were buddies.
Overeem and Arlovsky, not so much.
No.
We're not friends.
No.
We've like trained a couple of times and
Arlovsky
was saying Overeem's basically a dick. He's throwing knees and almost injured me. So
He has that reputation. I think he wasn't he in the Black Zillions for a while, right? Or something. Mm-hmm. He's had that rep kind of. He seems like the kind of guy who would do this shit. Like, you know.
Get a few shots know where in. That level is. There's a certain level where you can train hard, but you don't want to hurt your training partners.
Right.
And some people don't know where that switch is. Because I thought Hector Lombard was like that, too.
Also, yes. Yeah. Yeah. So. We'll see. I don't know how that fight's going to turn out. We'll have to see which Arlovsky shows up.
Yeah, it's a tough fight. You don't want to see one of those guys lose. It's the same thing with the Hunt versus Mir.
Mm-hmm.
Like, fuck. I don't want to see either of these guys lose. The Overeem. I mean, obviously, I want to root for Arlovsky, but... And then talk about body type with Overeem. Fuck, man. What happened?
It's all over the place.
You fuck it. You're a mess. You're doing this Wim Hof breathing. It's not helping your physique. No. Fucking, it's so depressing.
More steaks.
I need Uberim or
steaks
I go home.
Yes.
Let's get some ass the nuts.
Please.
So we were talking about Rory MacDonald earlier, and one website said Rory MacDonald was the most relevant fighter to test free agency. And I thought, that's curious. Who is the most relevant UFC fighter to test out free agency? And I'll give you the few that have come up of late. You have Overeem, Benson Henderson, Matt Mitrione, Gilbert Melendez, Rory MacDonald, or Aljamain Sterling.
Oh, for sure, MacDonald, I'd say.
You think so?
He's at the top of the list, yeah. That's why I think it's a big deal. If that guy takes off, young guy in the prime of his career, and has you know, been in the title mix and all kinds of things. And dude, he had that fucking war with Robbie Lawler. Mm-hmm. That was like, that could be up there with one of the greatest fights in the history of the sport. And they're going to let him go. I mean, it's a big deal. I think it's a huge deal. So he's obviously not happy with his pay. And I think that's been kind of the whole thing is like, these guys are going, wait a second, you guys are fucking making all this money. Well, how come we're not making any money? What's going on? So, and Bellator is like, come on over to the dark side.
Well, I wonder to that point, how much does that affect GSP coming back?
Probably a lot.
You know, Rory, and that's another thing where you got to think about the relationship that Rory has with GSP.
Yeah.
And you're going to shit on GSP on his way out or whatever he's doing. And then now you're shitting on Rory MacDonald. That's going to make it a little bit harder for GSP to even come back, I'm thinking.
You think so? Oh, I thought you were going to go in a different direction.
No.
I would say GSP would come back sooner because now his buddy's elsewhere. Well, he can come and do his work.
I can see it both ways.
Yeah.
If you want to think out of the loyalty aspect.
That's what I'm looking at.
How a Diaz brother, that's how I'm looking at it. Like, oh, man, you just shit on my brother?
I got you.
Well, we're fucking done.
Okay.
But if you're looking at it from the other side of the coin of, hey,
GSP's
now
get
he's
his
not going to be here, and now
he's getting
I don't
paid.
Have to fight him. But
he's getting, at least from one fight.
I think he's coming back from one fight. But going back to the original question, I would have to say out of the fighters I just listed, that Overeem, like who do you not want to lose out of that list? It's Overeem because of the heavyweights. And they were smart and they kept him. But if he goes over to fucking Bellator.
Oh, dude.
Then you get Uberim, you get him to fight fucking Fedor, You want to fight Kimbo? Fine. I'd make that fight happen. Like, done. Right away.
Yes.
You want to fight Ken Shamrock? Done. Yes.
Perfect.
Oh, murder fools. Yeah. Holy shit. So. And then along those same lines, if you're the UFC, looking at the current roster, who could you not afford to lose the free agency?
Anybody? Conor McGregor?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I think that's number one. Yeah. Right?
Shit. He's like your cash cow at this point.
Yeah. So. Could you imagine though? if shit hit the fan and.
Well, he keeps re-upping his contract, so I think he's.
Well, they probably
stuck.
Signed him to like a 21 fight deal. Whatever. That's what they like to do. Oh, we're going to lock you in for 15 fights.
You're so locked in, your children and their children are going to be fighting.
We own the naming rights to you and your next six children. They're all named UFC.
That's right.
Like George Foreman.
That's right.
Just, your name is George.
Oh, God.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Him for sure. Mm-hmm. Ah, damn. I'm trying to think who else. Who else could you not afford to
John
lose?
Jones?
Yeah.
That's a big one. When he got, when, if he.
I think you look at the pay-per-view numbers, right? Yeah. And that's probably going to dictate.
So Jones.
It's Conor. Does Ronda even matter at
this
point?
Yeah, oh, for sure. Ronda goes to Bellator, the comp. Or, well.
Who does she fight? That's the problem.
That's a problem. Mm. But you can't have her anywhere else. And she's got to stay
on. I mean, she'd just kill everybody in any other organization because now the UFC has the talent in that division.
This is weird. I feel like the tide is changing. It's like shifted in a strange direction. And if all it's going to take is a couple more pieces to fall in line. And now we have like some parity here where it's kind of, you know, hey, wait a second. These two organizations are fairly similar. So what are we
going to
do?
We're getting almost back to the Strikeforce days.
I like it.
Where that organization built itself up and really it was the heavyweight division. And you look at all the fighters that are in the UFC now that are champions that were in Strikeforce. You have Daniel Cormier, Fabricio Verdum, Robbie Lawler. Mm-hmm. Hey, fuck, man. What happens, and this trend is a little disturbing too, because then it goes back to, why would the UFC let these people go? If I'm the UFC, I don't let Rory MacDonald go.
Cash, man.
At all.
They don't want to pay a lot of money for anybody.
Well, is it because they're looking to sell, or is it because Conor McGregor's taking all the fucking money in the world?
Could be. You never want to put all your eggs in one basket.
Never.
A bad plan.
Never.
Yes. Diversify.
That's right. You got to diversify your assets.
Yes. With an emphasis on ass.
That's right. Eighth Wall on Twitter asks, would you like to see John Jones versus Daniel Cormier as one continuous 25-minute round? Yes or no, and why?
You know, if that were the case, I like Cormier's chances. But no. I would do a 5.
You want some pride?
Oh, yeah, dude. Let's do a 10-minute first round. I like that. Let's fucking do that. Let's see what happens, you know? I'm cool with this. And I think they should do this more. I mean, shit, maybe title fights should be 10-minute first rounds.
I'd like to see them at least test out some other options.
Yeah.
Because I feel like you can only do so much with 3 5-minute rounds or 5 5-minute rounds.
Right.
Again, we own the fucking pride name. We own the rule set. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you can't probably do it in the United States, but you fight in fucking how many other countries? We were just in Australia. Maybe you can't do that in Australia, but I'm sure you can find a country to do pride rules. I'm just saying.
Kazakhstan.
That's right. Do something different.
Yes.
A little bit of modifications. I'm open to, you know, extending that first round. Let's see what happens.
I like it.
You know, and especially when we're under this regime of rematches and threes and fours and five. What the fuck? If you're going to do it for 5 times, why not do some different rules? Do something different.
Yes.
Zeke Schwab, do you think the potential Diaz-McGregor rematch shows the lack of faith that the UFC has in McGregor beating Edgar? Or is it that McGregor can't make weight?
Ooh, that's an interesting question. I never thought of that angle. That might be part of it.
Dude, well, we forgot about that.
He got pretty fucking big for this fight. So maybe...
Because his coach was saying that, I don't ever want to see him go back to 145, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, he looked like hell in the last fight, the Aldo fight. Oh my God! It's like he got, when you look at the he got gradually worse and worse,
Auschwitz,
leading up to that. Oh, dude, looks like a totally different person. And we were talking about that. How he,
the hiv,
yeah. But I think it's more has to do with money. I think they're trying to really, they're going after the money fights. I mean, look, Rousey, Holm, all lost. You got Jones. Now, the one thing that would save them is if Jones comes back and just destroys, like, just fucking, just puts a beating on somebody. And that would be good for them. But then they have two guys who are exciting. And he needs to talk a lot of shit and be totally controversial and all that. Boom, right back in the mix. Mm-hmm. But right now, who else do you got? You got nobody. That's the fight. 200 is the biggest card ever, right? So, boom. They got to put the biggest guy on there.
But they're not pulling me in with the rematch, right?
Yeah.
Him versus Nate makes sense at a later date at 155.
That rhymes.
That rhymes. Like, that's all I'm saying. Yeah. Like, it doesn't make any sense right now. Yeah. I think it's just a diversion. They got something else going on. Maybe Fedor.
Ooh. Versus Conor?
I don't know.
Yes.
Something. Open weight, motherfucker. Come on. Come get some. Yes. I got mine.
A three-man tournament. Fedor, BJ Penn, Conor McGregor.
Or Rafael Dos Anjos talking about how he'd like to, I think he said he wanted to fight Conor McGregor and Nate Diaz both in one night. I could be both of them in one night.
Wow.
Okay. Tournament. One night.
I don't see that
happening. Let's do this.
But okay. Who are you going to fight first is the question.
If I'm Rafael Dos Anjos and I got to fight Nate and Conor, we'll fight Conor first.
Yeah.
And then Nate second.
Try to wrestle fuck him
for
a couple of rounds.
Try to conserve, because you could know you could take him down for, make it 3-5s. You can't do 2-5-5s.
Ooh. Nate's going to make it a war.
So. I know, so you're gonna try to wrestle fuck Conor in the first fight and get a decision and then go to war with Nate.
Yeah.
Because you beat Nate in the past, and you could probably leg kick him to death again.
Yeah.
Woo! We're on fire tonight.
Great question.
Alan Weir, who else do you think will make the switch to Bellator?
You know what? I feel like Frankie Edgar will. I think he's been pretty vocal about being upset about his contract. I feel like we're going to see a heavyweight crossover here shortly. I feel like they're due. They're building that division, and they need somebody else. And I don't know who it's going to be, but...
Frank Mir. No. I think Andrei Arlovsky would probably make a lot of sense over there.
Yeah.
And the crazy thing is, look at anybody in the top 10, instant champion.
Mm-hmm.
You know, fucking Matt Mitrione could be the Bellator champion for the next 5 years if they don't bring anybody else in. It's hard to say. I mean, fuck. But I think at the end of the day, if you are a UFC fighter, you need to be signing short fight contracts as far as like maybe 2 fights, 3 at the max, and then test free agency.
Yeah.
You have to. I mean, look at Matt Mitrione. If he's getting double what he was getting before, and you can get your own sponsors. He's getting $100,000 minimum.
Mm-hmm.
You kidding me? Fucking go over there.
Make that paper, man.
And even if it's just for, maybe you go over there for 2 or 3 fights, you've effectively gotten a raise, and now if the UFC wants you back, they have to pay that amount.
Mm-hmm.
And if they don't, fuck them. You're still making bank.
Mm-hmm.
And it's about making bank,
because your
career is not going to last. You are not an employee. You are an independent contractor in the UFC's eyes, so you should take well advantage of that.
Yes, I agree.
You're wearing a fucking uniform. You can't get your own sponsors. These assholes are waking you up at 4, 5, 6 o'clock in the morning and take your blood, piss, urine, I take piss and urine, and semen.
Blood, piss, urine, semen.
Whatever. 2, 3 fingers, however many they want to inject in you. You're taking it, fighters. You're taking it. You like that? I'm just saying. They're making you your bitch. Mm-hmm. Don't be a bitch. And Urijah Machado will close it out.
Oh, boy.
Would you rather try human breast milk or cheese made from human breast milk?
Do I get to pick if it's man or woman? Do men have breast milk? Is that possible?
Bigfoot Silva.
Oh, Jesus.
Lactating.
I'll do the cheese. You can at least put cheese on something. What are you doing?
I'd take it right from the tap, ladies. Right from the tap.
Depends. That's right. Squeeze the juice. Squeeze the juice.
It's very sugary.
Yes.
Would you rather have invisibility and teleportation at will, or the ability to read minds and fly?
Teleportation and invisibility.
Goddamn right. That's the right answer.
Yes.
I'll be invisible, and I'll be whacking off wherever I go, nonstop, just spooge dropping on ladies.
You probably don't even want to go in a ladies' locker room. You'd be like, it'd be one.
Well, if it's like the men's locker room, like, I want no part of the ladies' locker room.
Didn't they make a movie about this in the 80s or something?
Probably.
It's like kid goes invisible. Like, it'd be this. I bet you women are totally filthy and disgusting pigs. Like, in their own company, you just go, sure. Oh, like shitting and all this.
Yeah, you want no part of that. Maybe I do want a part of that. Maybe as long as they're shitting on my chest.
Okay.
What? Like,
hey, it's a German Chiza video.
Yeah.
Yes.
Fish hook that bitch. What? Someone said that. Fish hook that bitch while I fuck her. What? You can't say that.
Okay.
That's disgusting. No. I want to teleport too.
Yes.
Teleport right into You're someone's
like,
asshole.
I could just go home right now. And come back.
I'm
hungry, man. I'll be right back.
Boom.
Go home and have myself a sandwich and bring it home.
Yes. And the last question. Would you rather be a pirate or a ninja? That's a tough question. There's things we contemplate. We take shits.
I would say ninja because it's pretty fucking cool. I think they get to wear the whole uniform. Pirates are filthy. You know, ninjas sound like they're actually clean and stuff. Like they get their shit going on. Pirates is gross. Got the scurvy and all that stuff to deal with.
Yeah, just think what pirate tastes like. Not good.
No.
Not good. Mm-mm. But they get a lot of booty. And I'm down with the booty.
The pirate's booty?
I'm going to be a pirate.
Gluten free, by the way.
Bingo, I want to
be a
pirate. That
shit is the devil,
it
man.
You want some? I got a whole box. Sam's Club 30 pack of little individual bags.
Oh, that's smart. My kids buy the big bags.
No,
so fucking, I get like a little bowl. And then I'm like, oh, that was good. I think I have to have another one. And then like five bowls later, I'm going, fuck, I might as well just, I'm like, there's not, I'll just eat the bag. I'll get more tomorrow. My wife will come down, like the next year, like, seriously, you had to eat the whole fucking thing? Like, I'm sorry.
Got my way.
It just kind of happened.
If it gets in my way, I got to take care of business.
Like, you know, I was already halfway there. I was like, you know, what's another half?
And if I stop early, then I'm a quitter. You want to be married to a quitter?
That's right.
No.
Never go half-assed.
That's right.
All in.
Full retard or nothing.
So you'd rather be a pirate?
Goddamn right. Okay. I debated it, but it's all about the booty.
All right.
That's what's
the booty.
Deciding factor.
Okay.
You got any kind of knowledge for this week?
Knowledge, yes. I was telling you before we started taping, I started watching Vinyl on HBO.
Yeah.
I fucking love it. It's really good. If you're into like the it's like 70s. 70s? Yeah, I'm going to say 70s. 70s, 80s. Music era, New York. 70. Yeah, mid-70s. New York, like, there's a lot of booze and drugs and rock and roll and all this cool stuff. Great acting. Scorsese, I think Mick Jagger's involved. The story kind of takes a little while to get rolling. There's fucking hot chicks. The girl from House, the doctor girl. What the hell's her name? I don't remember.
I don't know.
Fucking hot. And you see, like, things. You can see things sometimes.
Things are good.
I urge you to check it out on HBO. And, you know. Thank you, HBO, for your sponsorship.
Yeah. we love you.
Yes.
And we got Game of Thrones coming back.
Yes.
And next month, like April 20th.
Yeah.
For around 420-ish.
Ooh. 420.
That would be right around UFC 197.
Okay.
423, I think. Jones Cormier.
I like it.
There's a lot of shit happening. So that would mean Silicon Valley's coming back around that time, too.
I love that show.
Again, I don't
fucking
understand.
Pied Piper. Oh, we never bought the shirts. I meant to buy them.
Yeah, see?
Damn it. I'm sure they still have them.
I'm sure. It'd be right. Like $5 by now.
Yeah.
They're on discount.
We should make our own.
That's right. We should.
I think we need BBC shirts.
We need something.
We probably get sued.
WBC.
Be really careful about how we do that.
But just tattoo it on your head. Don't be a bitch.
BBC. All day, son.
Like on your chin.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Why not?
All right.
Fucking slate. Shut it down.
All right, that's been this week's Dish. Now, maybe not. It's been anything a while.
Matt Griffith. Thanks for plans.